The final trim technique we will look at is known as sliding. This is when you take a segment and physically slide it along the sequence to change its actual position. So for example, I want an action to come later in the sequence. Even though I'm still in select mode, I can hold down D and quickly slide the segment to a new location in the sequence. Please note that you see the frame under the positioner update in the viewer as I slide the segment. This is not the same as regular select and drag. If I did the same without slide, the segment will be picked up, but you'll have no visual feedback in the viewer. So this is why sliding is great when adjusting the edit, and for quick adjustments, this is fine. However, for more precise adjustments, you can change the editorial mode from select to slide in the pull-down menu, or press the D keyboard shortcut. Change the player mode to trim view by using the pull-down menu or press Option 4. Alternatively, just double-click on a segment and the trim view will appear. In the center two viewers, you have the first and last frame of the currently selected segment. The viewer on the left is the outgoing frame of the previous segment. And the viewer on the right is the incoming frame of the next segment. This allows you to see the incoming and outgoing frames adjust around the current segment. You can slide the segment by clicking and dragging on it in the sequence. You will notice when sliding, the first and last frames of the sliding segment do not change in the trim view. I am just changing the segment's start and end point in the sequence. If you're more visually inclined, you can also click and drag in the viewers to drag the segment. Please note that when sliding with ripple on, only the outgoing frame of the previous segment is affected. Thus, the sequence gets shorter. If ripple is off, then both the outgoing frame from the previous segment and the incoming frame from the next segment will update. There are also buttons to slide the segment forward and back by 1 and 5 frames. You can also use the comma and full stop keyboard shortcuts to slide the segment by 1 frame forward or back. For numerical sliding, if you have a keyboard with a number pad, all you need to do is type plus 10, for example. Press Enter, and the segment will slide down the sequence by 10 frames. If you don't have a keyboard with a number pad, you need to hold Shift Option and double-click on the segment to bring up the trim calculator. Using the numeric keys on the keyboard, you can enter in your slide value of minus 5. Press Enter to slide the segment 5 frames back in the sequence. You can also press the play button to loop the segment repeatedly to review the edit. During playback, you can also press the comma and full stop keyboard shortcuts to slide the footage by 1 frame. Smoke will continue to review the edit with the new offset. Just stop the playback to exit the player. To move to different segments, just double-click on them and the view will change accordingly. To exit the trim view, just switch back to select mode by pressing the A keyboard shortcut. Finally, there are two other slide modes that you should be aware of. Looking at the editorial modes, you have slide cuts. This is not used very often, but this slide mode is the inverse of slip. Your source footage gets locked to the sequence, and you slide the cuts. So by starting the segment earlier in the sequence, also starts the source media earlier in the sequence. The last slide mode is slide keyframes. This mode works with all the timeline effects, with the exception of connect effects. For example, you have created an effect with a 2D transform timeline effects. You can slide the keyframes to start the effect sooner or later without having to go into the animation editor to make any changes. These are small but useful sliding tools. So that wraps up the trimming tools available in Autodesk Smoke. Please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.